Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest of spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have faith so as to move mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own and I hand my body over so that I may boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous. It is not inflated, it is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails.
Love, I said, is what brings all of you here. It is love that brings the two of them here. And of course, that love is not just a feeling, but it's a decision and a commitment that Charles and Sophia make today and then each and every day of their married lives. And of course, Scripture says that Christ loves the church as a husband loves his wife and a wife loves her husband, which raises marriage to a very sacred dignity. And I know that they are going to be wonderful mirrors of God's love in the world today. And so I want to thank them publicly for falling in love. I thank them publicly for getting married, because you really will be a sign to us of not only your love for each other, but your love for each other truly will mirror Christ's love for all of us.
Great woman, a great daughter, and that she will be a marvelous wife because of her nobility, honesty, and good intentions. I want to wish them both much happiness and many blessings. Sophia's mother couldn't be here, but she also sends her regards and her blessings to all who are here and who have welcomed her daughter into this family.
Have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you continue to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the laws of Christ in this church?
Yes.
Sophia, take this ring.
Sophia, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
Charles, take this ring.
Charles, take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And faithfulness.
I say, faithfully. Faithfully?
Mm-hmm. Receive these coins with the blessing of God, our Almighty Father, who provides for all of our needs. May you trust in Charles that he will always provide for you as God provides for all of us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Charles and Sophia, with this lasso, know that Christ binds you together, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health. May he always keep you close to him and close to one another. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Pleasure to present to you for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Charles Abraham.